sorry to be. Can you talk? This connection is terrible. Can you even hear me? It's hard to hear you too. I can't even explain why, but I thought I might feel better if I heard your voice. Steve, something awful. I've had a biopsy, Steve. No, damn it, I'm not all right. There's a malignancy in my left breast. The surgery is next week. Oh God, Steve, what if I don't make it through this? Steve, if this doesn't go well for me, it wouldn't matter to you, wouldn't it? I mean, we are something to each other, aren't we? Yes, yes, I know that. I just needed to hear it from you. I promise I'll call once it's all over.
For God's sake, who's crying?
It's you, dear. It's you who's crying.
Okay, can we stop you for a second?
I can see now why your talented heart is sustaining you. You have a wicked imagination.
That's a relief. I was afraid it was removed in the surgery.
I wouldn't think of changing the subject, but I'd like to tell you about a pilot study I'm running at the hospital to test the impact of medication support groups on breast cancer patients. This is a very promising drug I'll be prescribing you, called ASAP. It will reduce your chances of developing a tumor in the other breast.
Is that a big concern?
It's a concern.
What would I have to do?
You would attend a support group of other breast cancer patients once a week. You would take 20 milligrams of ASAP daily and see me for regular office visits for as long as you're active in the study.
I'm not sure I can do it.
Why?
Because I don't like talking to a bunch of strangers, and because I want to get past cancer, not dwell on it.
I can't argue with you about that, but bonding with other breast cancer patients can be so powerful that it's therapeutic.
The medication, what did you call it?
ASAP. It's the only real breakthrough we've had in preventing a recurrence.
Will it cure me?
I can't promise you that, but it's all we have.